Hey there, I'm Charlie, your online business manager and WordPress expert. My goal is to assist small to medium business owners build their businesses with a focus on using the internet and online technologies in an appropriate and cost-effective manner. People hire me to take the stress out of managing their businesses and allow themselves to focus on what they do best. Marco Torres is the founder of MarketingBoost.com and has helped thousands of business owners worldwide boost sales and scale their businesses by as much as fivefold through the use of incentive-based marketing. He teaches entrepreneurs how to source sales and marketing through the use of value-added incentives instead of discounts. His Facebook group is home to more than 27,000, wow, active business owners who are raking in sales with his advice and amazingly affordable subscription program. Hi, Marco. I'm so looking forward to talking to you today.
My pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me.
Look, fantastic. So why don't you, I've given everyone your blurb, the blurb that I ask people to give me when I do their intros, but why don't you give us just a bit of a helicopter view about you yourself and how you came to be here? Not here on the podcast.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah, no worries. Thanks for having me again. I have been an entrepreneur for most of my life. I started with at age 9, building the biggest paper out my local paper had ever seen. By age 12, I was featured on the front page of their paper for having built the biggest route. And then by age 23, I owned five restaurants and a nightclub. I went on to become an internet marketer as early as 1996, back in the days when it was pretty much just, before Facebook, before Google. It was the Wild Wild West on the internet, and I was heavily involved in getting involved in email marketing. I guess they called me a spammer before they ever even called it spam. We did a lot of emails in those days. Anyway, I've watched the evolution of the internet and generated in my career now for my own businesses and others over $1 billion in online transactions. And today I reach back and help other businesses grow with the use of incentives. And likely we'll talk about a little bit about that today as well, on how we help business owners grow their businesses now with using incentives to help whatever their call to action might be.
Look, that sounds fantastic. And it's just one thing I wanted to sort of reach out to my people and let them know that this is something that I really like to do is talk to people who have actually been there and done this, not the people that will end up in your emails or your DM saying, hey, I can help you raise $1 million in your business and not done a thing. Because their way of raising $1 million is to tell you how to do it. But someone
Right.
who has actually done it and is sharing their real life experience. So this is fantastic for me. I really, really, really enjoy these sorts of conversations. So let's get into it because you mentioned something there that I actually coach my clients with as well, and that's value add incentives. Let's talk about what they are, why they're important, and how they differ to discounting.
Absolutely. It's a good question. And, I don't know about in Australia, but I like to sometimes talk about examples that most people will relate to. And that is, does Amazon provide free shipping in and Amazon Prime in Australia? I figured so, but I hope.
We've just had some really big warehouses open up here as well. So yeah.
Cool. So I wasn't aware if they did that or not. But here's an example, everybody, assuming a lot of your listeners are in Australia, let me just to roll out some, this is an example everybody might relate to. And that is the incentive that Amazon, Jeff Bezos, one of the richest and most successful entrepreneurs, on the internet ever, he launched in 2005, rather, the incentive of free shipping when you purchased Amazon Prime. Back then, it was $79 a year, and that bought you the right to get free shipping, 2-day free shipping. We weren't really into the streaming video library that he had back then. That was, eventually we got into, hey, it's got a video library and other benefits. But the hook, the incentive was free shipping, and we bought into that. And now he's got loyal clients around the world that shop on Amazon. 70% of online searches for most products go to Amazon first. You can imagine the success that that has created. Another example that's very popular, people will recognize, is the McDonald's. They have the Happy Meal. They entice and incentivize parents around the globe who have children to choose McDonald's over other fast food outlets because they're helping the parents take their eye off of the price, focus on the prize, which is the bundle of the Happy Meal snack, the burger, the soda, the juice, the fruit, and the toy, the seasonal a toy that comes in the box. And people, they're rushing to get the new movie, Disney movie toy in the box and what have you. And the children are, so parents get a chance to actually maybe get in a word in edgewise over lunch while their children are entertained with the toy. So those are quick examples I want to, give people to begin to understand what I mean by incentive-based marketing. What are you doing? And whether it be obviously Marketing Boost, we'll talk about it. We provide incentives for you. But the key is, you may, if you can invent your own incentive, all the more power to you. If you can tie in with colleagues, and for example, if I'm a business coach and I sell a training system, and my colleague has a similar system but slightly different enough that we're not competitors, maybe we'll collaborate. And I'll say, when you buy my course, you get the first three chapters of my buddy's course over here, which is phenomenal. I teach you on sales. He teaches about marketing. So, when you buy my course, you get a portion of his course free. And he does the same. When he sells his marketing course, he offers your sales coach, training part of it for free. And then you both have the same leads to share and offer upsells to, for example. So, I mean, there's a lot of ways to be creative, but the key is, what can you do to create additional value add incentives? Maybe it's a book you wrote last year that when you sell your new book this year, you include, hey, bonus, added value. When you buy this book, my new book, or when you buy my new course, or when you hire me for 6 months, I throw in the 7th month free. What can you do to create value versus just saying, hey, if you pay me for 6 months in advance, we'll give you 20% off. That works too, maybe, but you're giving up your profits, and you'd be better off getting your full price and throwing in additional widgets, additional bonus, additional value somewhere. And Marketing Boost does that as well. We can talk about that later as well, but that's kind of my message here, is don't discount, because that can really be a race to the bottom.
Okay, so I'm going to just cover a couple of things there. First of all, you mentioned Amazon Prime and the free shipping. And most people now, when they think of Amazon Prime, as you said, think about the streaming services. I spend a lot of time in Hawaii, as people who know me will know that. And we were talking to a couple of mainlanders when I was over there, not this last trip, the trip before. I was talking to a couple of mainlanders, and they were talking about Amazon Prime in Hawaii. It's just really not, we're not getting the savings on the product that we normally get, because buying things in Hawaii is more expensive. They've got to ship them in, they've got to do things, there's things around that. But as my friend who had lived in Hawaii all her life said, yeah, but we get the free shipping. So we're not getting the deep discounts or the availability of stuff that, sorry, it wasn't the dis it wasn't the pricing, it was the quickness of the shipping. So 2-day free shipping sometimes doesn't occur. Getting things across the ditch into the island takes a lot, but they get the free shipping. And when you start to compare shipping of products to Hawaii from mainland US, that pricing looks fantastic after a while. So yeah, so
Right.
that for them, the benefit of Prime is not that you can get 2-day free shipping, it's that you get free shipping. It's just that shipping.
Even if it takes a
So
week, right? It's still free.
it's free and it's saving you. Like it could be 40 or $50 shipping sometimes, just for so. Like I know I was pricing items and they were going to cost me $15 and $30 for shipping. Why would you do that? So yeah, so that's a really, 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 really good one. The other one that you mentioned, and you said you started back in 1996. I didn't start quite so early, but I've been around for a little bit. And it was the adding in of bonuses when you're launching new products and launching new things. And you would remember the internet giveaways that used to happen. In fact, they still do. You just don't see them as much now, where you'd have a big product launch and you'd go out to all of your mates and say, "Hey, I'm launching something. I'm going to do a giveaway as part of it to build the marketing list and to get people interested and to drive sales. What can you offer? What would you like to offer that you can build your list with it? You can provide something, and I can provide it as a value add for buying my product." Such a great way of doing business, and we don't do that as often anymore. So I'd love to have some thoughts around that one as well. Now, you mentioned don't discount, you're giving away your profit. The difference, if you could just elucidate the difference between discounting and value add. I know you've already done it in one way, but if you could just make sure that's really clear to people, and then I want to cover what's the difference in your profit base if you're not offering a discount, but you're offering a value add? How is that not affecting your profit?
Well, let's talk about how the discount can dramatically affect your profit. For example, let's say you have a product you sell for $100, and at the end of after you have calculate your marketing expenses, your overhead, your staffing, your cost of acquisition, your advertising cost, et cetera, you average 20% net profit. So if after everything is done, you profit at 20%, and now you go ahead and say, "Hey, for this holiday period, I'm gonna give a 10% discount." Well, you just cut your profit in half. You went from 20% profit to 10%. Now, in order to end up in the same place, you need to sell, double the volume you did yesterday. So if you were doing $1,000 a day in sales yesterday, and you offer a 10% discount, again, now you're only getting that 10% profit instead of 20. So you have to end up with nearly $2,000 in daily sales with that discount to end up in the same net profit you had the day before. So that one, as little as 10%, if could be 50% of your profit, depending upon where you're at. You got to know your numbers. If you've got a higher margin than that, then maybe 10% is, well, workable. On the other hand, if you add value of something that doesn't necessarily cost you a lot of money, then you can hold your price or maybe even be charging more than you previously did because now you're adding additional widgets, additional, maybe things that don't cost you that much money. That's the key. Can you add more value with items that don't cost you a lot of money? If you don't mind, let me talk about how what Marketing
Go
Boost
for it.
offers that makes that possible. With Marketing Boost, and this came about, this idea launched in 2017, but what came about is an accident. I'll tell that story later if we have time. But today, what we do is we serve business owners around the globe. We have lots of members in Australia, actually, and throughout the United States, throughout Europe, and everywhere. And we provide what I call the wow, surprise, and delight factor. We provide travel incentives, complimentary hotel stays in 130 destinations around the world, from 3 to 7 night stays. Plus, we have hotel savings cards that come in increments of one, two, three, and $500. They work kind of like a gift card, but they don't pay for the entire hotel stay, but they'll discount compared to the Expedia's, Priceline.com, et cetera. And then we have restaurant savings vouchers. The restaurant vouchers we offer are only good in the United States and Canada. But the complimentary hotel stays, we have a bunch of them in Australia, destinations in Australia. They don't include airfare or transportation to and from your home to the hotel. They don't include food and beverage at the hotel. And they don't include the government taxes and fees that are required at check-in. So but you're as a business owner, we give for a one low fee, a monthly fee, a subscription fee, we make it incredibly affordable for any business owner to add a 3-night stay in Sydney, for example, or in
Oh,
Brisbane, or many
wow.
others, to your clients for taking your call to action. So, for example, Charlie, you might say, when you hire me as your business coach, and when you reach your 6 months anniversary, or if you pay for 6 months in advance, I'm going to reward you with four, five or seven nights in Bali, or I'm going to give you, I think we have a 5-night stay in Bali. Or you might say, I'll give you a 7-night stay in Phuket, Thailand on us. It doesn't, the disclaimers, it doesn't include airfare, it doesn't include food and beverage or government taxes and fees, but I'll cover your, hotel stay in Thailand, in Phuket, Thailand, when you reach the 12, 12-month anniversary, or when you pay for 6 months in advance, or when you, do whatever it is you'd like them to do in your value stack, in your call to action. You might offer a hotel savings card for a smaller call to action. So, for example, you might say, this is how many of our members use it. Everybody today, we like using Zoom calls a lot now, right? We have sales teams or ourselves. You need to get people on a Zoom call with you to interview, to see if it's a good fit to work together. People book on your calendar, and how many end up being no-shows? Well, you might offer a travel reward, an incentive, as part of the reason to go ahead and book your call when you're soliciting prospects on LinkedIn. You might say, hey, if you book a call with me, whether we end up doing business or not, I'm going to reward you with a $300 hotel savings card, good at 1 million hotels worldwide, if you book that appointment with me and, of course, show up on time. And now your reminder messages, your automation that you might set up to send them an email saying, don't forget tomorrow, we're scheduled at 2 o'clock. And at 1 o'clock, you get another message right before the meeting is, don't forget to, we're meeting in an hour. Well, that might also include, don't forget, I'm rewarding you with a $300 hotel savings card when you show up on time for our scheduled meeting. That's going to help you two things. One, get more bookings for you or your salespeople. And two, it's going to get more people to show up. And those two, if you did that alone could help you, fill your calendar and keep everybody showing up. Therefore, you're going to likely do what? Sell more. And then you might get them, once you get them on the phone, you might say, super, this is what we do. And by the way, if you take action, I have a few of these left. You can create scarcity and urgency, a reason to do business with you today. You might say, by the way, if you do take action this week, I've got a few of these left. I have a great relationship with my travel partner, and I have, a few of these getaways and your choice of Brisbane or Sydney or whatever. I've got a half a dozen destinations in Australia or more. I forget how many there are, 10 or 12. Anyway, you could then say, I'll give you your choice of 3 nights in one of these destinations on us if you go ahead and pay in advance, or if you, sign up this week, or if you, what again, whatever your call to action is. And the higher, the higher ticket it is, the more it makes sense, the more believable that bonus incentive is. And yet it doesn't cost you anything but our monthly subscription, which, by the way, Charlie, it's only $37 a month to be a member of Marketing Boost, $37 US a month. So it's very, very affordable for any solopreneur, entrepreneur, wannabe entrepreneur, direct salesperson. Anybody can really afford this so that they can use these incentives to add, again, add value, create engagement, create loyalty programs, trade show giveaways. I mean, there's, if you have a little bit of creativity, these can be used in a whole myriad of ways to create that, what I talk about, adding value versus discounting. Again, I preach, if you can create your own added value, all the more power to you, and you should do that anyway. But our incentives can just be that extra bullet that helps people get off the fence and do business with you, or get, give you referrals. I mean, you could tie the incentive to, if you refer us to six of your friends and relative, or what have you, we'll reward you with a complimentary hotel stay or a $500 hotel savings card. And again, so you can use them for referrals. You can use them for even for, I'll give you ideas on how people can use them to even control and manage their online reputation as well.
Okay, so you've said a heap of stuff there, and
Yeah,
that
I'm
sounds
sorry. I kept rambling
fantastic.
away. Once I
No, no,
get
no, no, no,
going.
it's fine. And I didn't want to sort of interrupt because you're on the roll. I could see it, and I'm like, yeah, this is all really good. There's a couple of things I do want to sort of hit back on there. One of the things that some of us in the space have issues with, and I'm sure my listeners are going to say, yeah, but how do we do it for our, how do we create incentives within our own business using our own things? As you said, you've got something that people can take advantage of. But when you provide online services and you provide online coaching, and the only, generally you think, oh, the incentive I can offer is you get an hour of my time every 6 months. Well, that's cutting into your profit. That's cutting into your time. And that bit ties you back into the picture when you're trying to sort of increase things without doing a whole heap more. Sometimes you have to, but it works smart, not harder, work smarter. So if you can find something that doesn't cost you a heap that you can just throw out as part of your incentives, that's a great way of doing it. The other thing that I really wanted to highlight is that one of the things that I see as a difference between incentives and discounting is that the incentives are a value add. They're adding value to what you're already offering, whereas a discount is taking value out of your own business. You are actually saying to your client base, my services aren't worth what they say they're worth. They're actually worth 10 or 20% less. Because I can offer this discount as a one-off or as a special. And once that person comes back to you and says, but I want to renew, what's my discount? You're in a lot of trouble because you've got to then
Yes,
say, well, no.
you took, yeah, that's taking words out of my mouth that I usually say as well, because when you discount, you're also educating your community or your clients to not take action with you next time until you offer another promo round or another discount round, or as you just said, I want to renew. What's my discount this period or this year, and so on. And you're educating them to solicit a discount, and then you feel kind of obligated to, or you don't want to lose the client, so you're like, well, okay, here's another discount, and it does cheapen yourself versus trying to hold that price and see what other added value you can do. So it is a you are creating a bad habit and training your own clients to expect more. And not do, and at the end of the day, Charlie, I'm sure you'd agree with me. There's really, for anybody listening, there's really only two, maybe three ways, and it really breaks down to two ways to grow your business. One, you need more customers. That's one way. You need more customers, which means that's why I say three. Well, you need more leads so that you can generate more customers. Now, the third way to grow your business, you either need those same customers to buy more often, or buy a higher ticket item. They
Or
either spend
spend more.
more at one shot or they buy more often. So that's your, how do you get people, more customers, and the ones that you do have to buy more often or come back and buy again? Or do you get, people to spend more on each occasion? So that's the only really two ways to grow your business. More customers, get them to spend more, make them more valuable. How do you do that? And that's where you need to, in part, hold your price to, be able to encourage them to spend more, generating rewards, loyalty programs, and so on.
Absolutely. And anyone who's done any business training should know that those are the two ways to grow your business. I mean, people might say you should diversify, but that just comes down to getting people to buy more from you. Might be different things this time, that's all. But that then leads into one of the other questions that I had, or one of the other things I wanted to discuss, and that's why is having a good customer a good idea? Like, why is that a great draw card for your business? And I think we've already touched on that. So let's dig into that a little.
Okay, on the on having a customer draw card, is that what you're the question? Yeah, the
What
customer.
a good customer. Let's talk about having good customers.
Well, that's the other good thing I like about being in business for myself, right? I've fired customers before as well, so I'm a believer in, if we're not a good fit to work together, then the other problem you have with discounting, it comes from generating what might be a bad customer. When you discount, I've always found the people that did demand a discount and you did give in and you gave them a discount end up being the hardest ones to work with. They expect the most. They're over, they're demanding way much more than the time that you're agreed to participate in developing or helping them with their project or what have you. And their expectations are unbelievable, and they still want it for less money. On the other hand, when people pay you, when you find the right client who sees your value, pays you your full price, you normally find those are the good customers, are the ones that will take your advice as you present it. They will, work with you as you were hoping they would. And those are, and then of course, with that good customer, you're going to be soliciting referrals and rewarding them for sending you referrals, and they're going to send you similar customers, those good customers that we talked that you're talking about. I think that's where you're going with that. Is that right, Charlie?
Absolutely. And there's a few things that you hit on there, and that's, I find it the most amazing situation when you do discount for someone and they are probably your most demanding and difficult customer to work with, and you think, oh, I've just charged this other customer all this money, they're going to be so demanding, they're going to want all these things, and they're the most chill. They are so chill. They're like, yeah, whatever you think is best. I'm paying you. I know you know what you're doing. Just
You're the
okay,
expert. Oh.
you think that's a great idea. Let's go and do that. And it blows me away every time. I don't know why after all these years, but it does. And I agree with you entirely. And I think that kind of highlights why it's important to make sure you've got a good customer from the beginning, and your whole lead generation process filters out some of those as well.
Now, speaking of lead generation ideas, I'd like to throw out some ideas because, again, to grow your business, you need more leads and get those to convert to more sales. One of the ways that I've coached and successfully seen a lot of Marketing Boost members grow their business is with a good lead magnet. And so, what does that mean? As a business owner, one of the ways today to set yourself up apart, stand out from the crowd, to establish yourself as the business, the authority, the expert in your realm, your circle, is to be providing content, to be providing free content. Maybe it's a video training series, maybe it's a PDF download, maybe, if you're a realtor, you do webinars, live events, or video training on, hey, how to get your home ready to sell fast. How to buy a home with, low to bad credit, whatever it is, you're providing content that people can consume for free or next to free. And as they're downloading or watching those videos, watching that training, they're seeing you as that expert and authority. And when they're ready to buy, occasionally in your offers, you're asking or you're providing an offer to get them to take action. But one of the things we found that our incentives help people do is get them to download that in those info kits, that PDF, that lead magnet, whether it be, register to receive my free training video training series. Now you might add, for example, when you download my free video training series or my free PDF training on the following subject, I'm going to also give you a $100 hotel savings card as our gift when you download our PDF. So you've added an extra value incentive over and above your info kit so that they'll give you an accurate name, phone number, and email to get, your information kit and the bonus. And now you're acquiring, and you've got to be building a database in today's world. If you're not capturing email, phone number, and email so that you can grab those leads, own that data, and be sending them now a drip campaign of email, voicemail broadcasting, text messaging, where you are reaching out, nurturing them from a lead to a warm prospect to eventually a client. And so our incentives or some incentive, be it ours or anything else, find something that'll help make sure you're gathering quality and constant new leads.
So there's a couple of things.